Hello, I'm Gene Therapy, and I want to pump you up. Ow. Hey there, Hanses and Franzes. Trace here for DNews. Thanks for watching. It seems like sports ball isn't really about the actual sports anymore, but more about the drama of players' lives and how they made themselves into the buff pieces of gentleman or lady meat that they are today. Part of that massive swirling narrative is the accusation that some sports stars cheat. Whether it's blood doping, deflating the game ball, or taking various myriad drugs, it's all about using science to gain the high ground. And now, gene therapy might have changed athletics forever. We talked about gene therapy before, you know, because you subscribe to DNews, because you do subscribe to DNews, don't you? Gene therapy is a genetic modification of someone who's grown. It doesn't permanently change their genetics, but it can alter them. A retrovirus, called a vector, is genetically engineered to enter the cells of the patient and alter just a little bit of their DNA, something viruses do naturally. Gene therapy is used to cure genetic disorders, but this is different. Rather than infecting the person to cure something, this vector is programmed to modify an athlete's DNA. Say, to make their red blood cells carry more oxygen, make their muscle mass increase, or whatever. It's called gene doping, and it effectively makes athletes superhuman. The World Anti-Doping Agency, an organization dedicated to fairness in athletics, created an expert group to root out any gene doping way before it started actually happening. They're recognizing that it's difficult to catch and a worrying trend in sports. Gene doping is difficult to detect as it simply makes the athlete's body better at doing something it kind of can already do. And it's already started. Experiments at Harvard in 1999 created genetically modified mice where a gene called IGF-1 was altered. These modified mice had two copies, whereas most mice only had one. The gene normally affects a protein called myostatin. The increased myostatin levels allowed the mice to put on more muscle mass while exercising. The genetically altered mice got 30% stronger, and this is the same protein that we have, so maybe humans? But that's not all. In 2004, experiments at the Salk Institute of Biological Studies found the PPAR-Delta gene, which, when altered, lets mice run twice as far for nearly twice as long as regular mice. The Harvard researchers said, "We certainly have no plans to add the gene to human embryos, but of course with gene doping, we wouldn't actually need to." In the late 90s, cyclists in the Tour de France were famously caught injecting their muscles with something called EPO, which causes increased red blood cell production. Because the body produces it naturally, injections are really hard to catch, but gene doping might make it impossible to catch. Of course, modifying mice is a far cry from modifying humans. The WADA announced adding an extra copy of the EPO gene could be deadly, causing the blood to over-thicken and become kind of sludgy. Gene therapy and doping is still highly experimental. Even though we've sequenced the human genome, there is just too much information in there to point to exact genes and hook them up with their athletic ability. But scientists are, of course, looking. They've counted 220 genes so far. If we could safely modify the genetics of a living human, we could potentially make people stronger, faster, with higher endurance, more resistant to disease and to pain, all with things already in our own bodies. But obviously, there are dangers to be avoided. The research base is there, and when it comes to sports, the money is there, so it's only a matter of time. For now, we can enjoy the benefits of other insane augmentations. Toyota has been doing some tinkering of their own with the TRD line of Toyota trucks. They're enhanced to rule the off-road. If you could make yourself stronger, faster, or, you know, whatever, would you? What natural thing would you want to make super? Let us know in the comments. Thanks for watching DNews. Make sure you subscribe so you get all our videos every day, and we'll see you tomorrow.